Okay, good morning. We're at the end of week five here, and yesterday we did 7.1, 1 through 26, I believe it was, and we're going to go over 7.1 right here in the bellwork. So take a look. We have points A and B right here, and I want you to do all three transformations to it. And if you look here, let's go over this right now. This one right here, it says, take A and B and go 2 units down. Well, if you're going to go 2 units down, you're going to subtract 2 on your Y. And then it says 5 units to the right. Well, 5 units to the right is going to be a plus 5 on the X. So what you're going to end up with is A prime and B prime for number 1. And here you're going to end up with 5 minus 2 is 3, 7 minus 2 is 5. That's the new point. And then right here, you're going to get 7, it looks like, and then 6, 8 minus 2. And that's all you do to slide it, which is called a translation. All right, the next one is reflect. Remember, if you reflect it over the x-axis, you change the y. So here, that's your y, and that's your y right there. So you're going to change them. So for 2a, you're going to say a prime and b prime, and you're going to change the y's. So it's going to be negative 2, negative 7, and 2, and negative 8. Okay, and then finally B wants you to go over the y-axis, so you're going to change the x. You always change the other one. So here's your x's right here. So A prime and B prime are going to change the x's. So it's going to be 2 and 7, and negative 2 and 8. And that's all there is to a reflection. A reflection is a flip, okay? So if you go over the X, you change the Y. If you go over the Y, you change the X. Real simple. All right, and then finally the rotation. Well, we're going to have to look at the rules for these. And I'm looking on the board right now. So 90 degrees counterclockwise is going to be negative Y and X, okay? And then the next one, 180 degrees either direction, would be a negative X and a negative Y. And that doesn't really mean negative. What it means is change the X and change the Y. And then finally, the last rule is 90 degrees clockwise. And 90 degrees clockwise up on the board is going to be switch them, but you change the X. Remember, this negative does not mean that it's a negative. It means change it. So if it is a negative, you would put a positive. Okay, so change it. All right, so let's do this. 90 degrees clockwise, and here's clockwise right here. So we got to switch them and change the X. So you're going to have your points, which are way up here. Let me pull this down a little bit. So point A is we're going to get A prime and B prime. And we're looking at 3A, and we're going 90 degrees clockwise. And here it is right here. So we're going to switch them and change the X. I'm going to change the X first, which would be 2, so the answer would be 7 and 2. I'm going to change the X, which is a negative 2, and then switch them, so I'm going to get 8 and negative 2, and that should be clockwise. 3B, when we go, 180 degrees, you don't switch them, but you change both of them. So A prime, on this one, you're going to change and change, so that's going to be 2 and negative 7. And then B prime, you're going to change and change, so that's going to be negative 2 and negative 8. And that should be 180 degrees in either direction. And then finally, the last one is 90 degrees counterclockwise. That one, I believe you switch and change the Y. Switch them and change the Y. And that is exactly what it is. So you're looking at your points way up here. So let's change the Y first. So that's going to become a negative 7. And then negative 2 is going to stay. This becomes a negative 8, B prime. So that becomes a negative 8 and 2. And that's it. It's really pretty easy. All right, put away your bellwork. Now I want you to look at 7.2. And this is the last section we're going to do for this week before we go to break. Tomorrow we'll watch a little movie, and then we'll relax over the holidays. The question is, identify the transformation. Remember, there's three transformations. You're going to slide it, you're going to rotate it, or you're going to flip it. Those are the three. Okay? So if you look here, this looks like a flip. So I'm going to say this is a flip or reflection. Remember, reflection is a flip. Now they want you to go ahead and identify the corresponding angles and then write a congruent statement. Now the congruent statement I'm going to do first. So I'm going to say triangle on this one, and it doesn't matter how you do it, okay? If I go ABC, I'm going short leg to long leg. So I'm going to say triangle ABC is congruent to triangle, and I'm going to go short leg to long leg. It has to be ZXY. ZXY. Make sure that you do the same order for your triangles. Doesn't matter how you order the first one, but the second one has to be the same. And again, I did ABC, so I went short leg, long leg. So short leg, long leg would be right there. And then they want you to identify the congruent angles and sides. Okay? Well, to do the congruent sides, you're going to do the first two over the first two. So AB segment is congruent to ZX. And then the second two, BC, is congruent to the second two, which is XY. And then finally, the first and last, which is AC, is congruent to Z and Y. Okay? And then they want you to do the angles. So angle A and Z are congruent. So angle A is congruent to angle Z. And then B and X, and I'm just going to abbreviate here to make it a little easier, and then C and Y. And that's it. And that's how they want you to do the first few problems here. It looks like 1 through, 1 through 10 is going to be that way. Again, this one right here, if you look at it, number 9, it looks like a flip. So that's a reflection. Okay, you could also probably say 90 degrees counterclockwise or 90 degrees clockwise, depending on which one you're starting with. Okay, this one right here, I would say it's a definite 180 degree rotation. Okay, all right, and then you got to identify the similar triangles, just like I did in number 1. And then finally, to round up today's work, it's basically the same thing. You're going to identify the first two over the first two, second two over the second two, first and last, and then angle A and B and E and C and U and D are all congruent. Okay, that's pretty much it. Today's work is 7.2, 1 through 18. Okay, and make sure you draw diagrams, as always, and show all work. Okay, if you finish this one and you did not finish 7.1, please do so. All right, we're going to start 7.3 when we get back from the break. And remember, Carnegie is due Thursday night, but I'm not making you work over break besides that. Okay, we're just trying to end up the 2 weeks that I gave you already. All right, well, have a good morning, and I'll see you in class.